On November 23rd, we visited the modern extensive facility that houses the National Museum of the Mighty 8th Air Force in Pooler, Georgia. The museum educates visitors on the history of the 8th Air Force of the United States Army Air Corps that served in the European theater during World War II. The rotunda is dedicated to Major General Lewis E. Lyle, United States Air Force retired, a B-17 veteran of 70 combat missions during World War II, who, with the help of other veterans, planned and saw their vision become a reality with the dedication of this museum honoring the men and women who helped defeat Nazi aggression by serving in or supporting the greatest air armada the world had ever seen. Bronze bust of General James Doolittle, United States Air Force, who was a pioneer in instrument flying and air racing in the emerging days of aviation. He led the 8th in the final defeat of the German Luftwaffe, German for Air Force. The Prelude to World War II exhibit chronicles the conditions that allowed Adolf Hitler and his Nazi Party to win the support of the German public and his ambitions for Europe to be dominated by the Third Reich. Once Hitler and the Axis powers conquered the majority of Europe and Northern Africa, he turned his attention to the United Kingdom. The Battle of Britain exhibit highlights the fortitude of the British people, who were able to keep calm and carry on under the leadership of Prime Minister Winston Churchill. While Germany was wreaking havoc in Europe and Asia, its ally Japan escalated its own campaign of conquest in the Pacific theater. The Day of Infamy exhibit examines the events surrounding the Japanese surprise attack on Pearl Harbor on December 7, 1941, launching the United States into World War II. After the Germans and the Italians declared war on the United States on December 11, 1941, the U.S. and its allies must come up with a plan to win the war with fronts on opposite sides of the globe. On January 28, 1942, 53 days after the infamous attack on Pearl Harbor, the 8th Air Force was officially activated in the National Guard Armory on Bull Street in Savannah, Georgia. The From Savannah to the UK exhibit examines the creation of the 8th Air Force in Savannah, Georgia on January 28, 1942. The 8th's objective was twofold: help the British Royal Air Force cripple Hitler's war-making capability by bombing anything that helped Germany continue to wage war, and to defeat the formidable German Luftwaffe so that a land invasion could eventually be made. Flying from bases in England, the 8th Air Force played a major role in turning the tide of the air war in the European theater of operations. The Combat Gallery houses original aircraft engines and scale models, as well as a multitude of exhibits. Inside the gallery is the museum's very own B-17 Flying Fortress, which is being restored as the City of Savannah. The original City of Savannah was the 5000th airplane to have been processed through Hunter Army Airfield in Savannah during World War II. Once completed, the new City of Savannah will be the first static display of a B-17 in the world. In 1944, B-17 Lovely Julie took a direct hit on the nose from a German 88 anti-aircraft, shattering it as far as the cockpit. The Tauglieder was killed instantly. The pilot miraculously flew the aircraft back to base and was awarded the Silver Star for this accomplishment. The POW exhibit explores daily life for those airmen captured by the Germans, including an examination of their treatment and living conditions. A display case features a handkerchief embroidered by a prisoner of war to pass the time in Stalag Luft IV. The embroidered handkerchief was emblematic of his time as flight engineer and top turret gunner in the 489th Bomb Group. The Escape and Evasion exhibit takes visitors into a safe house, set up as it would have been by individuals who were part of the resistance in France, Belgium, and the Netherlands. This exhibit is dedicated to those helpers and their families in occupied Europe who risked their lives during World War II, hiding and moving downed Allied airmen through enemy lines to freedom. This A2 jacket assigned to Louis Allen, who flew 25 combat missions between 6 March 1944 and 14 April 1945, reflects the fact that he flew more missions on the B-17 Miss Fortune than on any other Flying Fortress. On display, the last remnant of the B-17 Flying Fortress, Eager Beaver, that made the trek to England and flew its first mission on 9 October 1942. Eventually, the Eager Beaver flew 45 combat missions, including the first daylight raid on Germany on 27 January 1943, before it was returned to the United States in 1944. The Memorial Gardens are a quiet testament to the cherished memory of our veterans. The winding paths around the dramatic reflecting pool are lined by stone walls and granite monuments with the names of those who valiantly served their country.
In that small cafe, the park across the way, the children's carousel, the chestnut trees, the wishing well. I'll be seeing you in every lovely summer's day, in everything that's light and gay. I'll always think of you that way. I'll find you in the morning sun, and when...
Overlooking this reflecting pool is a life-size bronze statue of 351st Bomb Group Navigator Ben Love, sculpted with great realism and standing in his A2 jacket. This statue is now a symbol for all who served in the 8th Air Force during World War II.
Carousel, the chestnut trees, the wishing well.
The beautiful stone Chapel of the Fallen Eagles is built to resemble an English chapel and is meant to give visitors a place to reflect on the sacrifices made by our veterans.
Think of you that way. I'll find you in the morning sun, and when the night is new, I'll be looking at the moon, but I'll be seeing you.
Behind the museum in the Memorial Gardens is a B-47 Stratojet. This aircraft could fly at high altitudes to avoid detection and was pivotal as a nuclear deterrent, as it was able to be ready within minutes to drop nuclear bombs on the Soviet Union if necessary. This aircraft was America's first swept-wing jet bomber and helped lead to the modern jet airlines.